Excellent. Thank you. We are going to part six of attitude dictates altitude. Attitude dictates altitude. This is part six. What is attitude and what is altitude? And for Nika, you said the altitude is, for the sake of this message, great height. Great height, which you can get on in any venture, in anything in life. And then, attitude, for the sake of this message, based from this dictionary, will be the way a person views life or tends to behave towards it. The way a person feels like, the way we look at life, or the way we tend to behave towards life is attitude. And we have handled so many things. In part five, we were able to handle the issue of how did I become like this, and we treated that event, and then we were able to go through certain things that can influence attitude. Then also in that part five, we're able to explore factors that can shape attitude. So we spoke on personality, we spoke of environment, we spoke on words, we spoke on self-image as to factors that can shape attitude. We also were able to explain experiences as one of those factors, peer influence as one of those factors. And then we were able to explain certain things on accountability. Accountability, how accountability is the key for change. We gave so many stories of that. In this part six, I would like us to go through certain factors also, or certain things about negative, or the negative things on attitude. You know, what negative effect we can have on attitude. And on this negative attitude, or negative effect on attitude, we're able to explain certain things, the danger that are in this, or danger of negative attitude. And I was able to come up with about six of these dangers, and it can be permit us, after we will have explained that, then we shall go into certain truths. Truths about attitude. And what we're going to do in this part six. So we're going to enjoy this part six. So let's begin to go through that certain things introduction before we go into the actual dangers and then the truth or certain truth on attitude. So attitude is the way we feel life. The way we behave towards events in life is attitude. So attitude is developed. So, and I have said over and over again that nobody is born with good or bad attitude, negative or positive attitude. So we can develop attitude. So attitude is a choice. You cannot be forced to have any particular attitude. So it's a choice. So nobody forces you to think, feel or behave the way you do. So it's your choice. Therefore, attitude is a choice. So it means we can always change it. If we can look at this topic, attitude is something that affects every aspect of our lives. Spiritually, our gifts, how we handle things, secularly, attitude. So it's very important we understand this. That's why I try to take time to explain it to us. So the circumstances you don't choose. We don't choose circumstances. As we continue to live our life, we'll be going to continue to face certain circumstances in life. But your attitude, you choose. So how we respond to circumstances in life, we choose that. So attitudes are not formed automatically. That we have to understand. Or at random. Attitudes are not shaped in a vacuum. There are factors that contribute to the shaping of attitudes. But I will ask you in this part six, where do you actually belong? Let's look at that. Where do you belong? Are you an optimist person, or you are a pessimist person? Do you have a negative attitude, or you have a positive attitude? So where do you belong? You got to belong somewhere. And we have to be very honest with ourselves. And that's why we begin to argue or we begin to treat this kind of topic, attitude. Be honest with yourself, to look at yourself and look at events in your life and begin to make changes if there's a need to make changes, or begin to improve if there's a need to improve on some things. Sometimes we may be thinking that if we are born again or if we're a Christian, then automatically our attitude will change. But it doesn't go that way. Because we're a Christian, because we are born again, that does not necessarily mean that your attitude will automatically change. You can't say, my attitude has to be good because now I'm a Christian. That is not the case. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 23 to 30, 24 explains this verse very carefully. It says, Ephesians 4 from verse 23, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. So there's a need for renewal. You begin to renew the spirit of your mind so that what is happening inside begin to affect the outside. And he said, and that you put on the new man which was created according to God. You put on the new man, you respond to your conversion, the shape that you have in true righteousness and holiness. Philippians 2:5 said, let this mind be in you which was also in Christ Jesus. So, because you are not a Christian, because you are not born again, does not mean that automatically your attitude will change. If you have, you have a negative attitude, don't ever think that it's going to change automatically because now you are a Christian. So you need to work on it, you need to continue to get, renewed in your mind. And as that begins to happen in your mind, it begins to affect the outside. Remember that transformation comes not by trying, but transformation can come only by training. So begin to train the way you think, begin to train the way you attend to issues, begin to think, train the way you respond to circumstances in life. And then begin to get developed and train yourself to show maturity in many, many things that we have. So negative attitude, let's look at that. To understand these topics well enough, this series of some, to understand this well, we need to understand negative attitude. And as you understand negative attitude, it will help you also to understand positive attitude. So I'm taking time to put certain things down about negative attitude. Now, in the midst of the negative attitude of millions of Israelites that left Egypt, some of them came up and have the attitude that is positive. You could say majority, that is true. There are so many people facing challenges today. So the majority of people have negative attitude. But that does not mean that you cannot develop yourself and be positive in the way you see things in life, in your attitude towards things in life. We'll explain that as we continue in this topic. So the danger of negative attitude. What are the dangers we can encounter if we approach life in a negative way? This topic is coming to you so that you will see that you have what you think of, or you get what you want in life based on your understanding of certain things that the Word of God is explaining to us. If you don't understand this issue carefully, it will go a long way to affect the level you get in life. And if you understand this topic carefully, it will go a long way to affect the height you get to in life, because attitude dictates quality. So let me explain certain dangers. I will give five or six dangers of negative attitude. The first one, negative attitude creates shadows of doubt. It creates shadows of doubt. It creates so many doubts in our heart. People with a negative attitude seldom expect good things to come their way. If you have a negative attitude, you will be thinking that, well, that is my destiny. In our family it's very hard. I think it's a generational curse. That's how that to be, you just live with it like that. Well, that is how life used to be. It's going to be so hard. They always embrace the worst possible outcome. People with negative attitude, they embrace, they encourage worst possible outcome to life. In fact, they will have concluded the situation. They will have concluded the results before things even happen. And their attitude becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. They will prophesy the end of the issue. They will prophesy problem themselves. Because of the fact that they've embraced negative attitude. So we need to understand these things very carefully. And we train ourselves. Transformation, we have to come by training. You train yourself so you can transform. You don't like it. That's one good thing about attitude. You don't like it, you can change it. If you understand what I'm saying now, you can apply it to your life and you begin to see changes. See, changes will come. When you train yourself in a certain pattern, changes will eventually come. Remember, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Most things that will happen to us, we need to have faith. Sometimes things will happen to us as if there is nothing anybody can do. It is doomed. But by faith, you can scale above every obstacle. By faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith. And without faith, you cannot please God. Even when things are happening to you, as if God is dead, then you, with faith, you say, my God is not dead. When things are happening to you, as if, how am I the only one? Why am I being beaten all over? You still continue to trust God. That if God gives me every day, I will continue to trust Him. Where shall we go? Where shall we go? When events begin to happen, you get so encouraged. Oftentimes people, when things begin to happen to them, that's when they withdraw from God. Now if you withdraw from God in a hard situation, how do you think God will trust you, that you come close to Him, even when things are becoming comfortable? Faith. Without it, it is impossible to please God. Negative attitude blows problems out of proportion. That's number two. Negative attitude, we blow things out of proportion. A little leak from the roof, we say, oh, this is hurricane. It is falling. Little leak from the roof. Negative attitude, we blow things out of proportion. Little things, we exaggerate things out of proportion. That's why we need to understand we must not encourage negative attitude. Hello? You must not. Be positive in your heart. With God, all things are possible. So some people, they make drama out of every situation. They make drama. Any situation, they will make drama. You see them, and it's good. Nothing. Nobody laughs. Relax. You will be, there's nothing new under heaven. If you think yours is the worst case, you have to listen to people and see what they are passing through. You think yours is the worst? Until you hear other people's story, you will roll on the ground and say, God, I thank you for my own. If this is this one, I'm thankful to God. You will be thankful to God. So, negative attitude blows things out of proportion. And we will get to a level where we see the truth about this. And you know, this thing is contagious. Somebody has negative attitude around you, it could easily affect you. If you don't understand what we are talking about now in this under this message, it will affect you. They treat them in. Rather than see the solution in every problem, they see problem in every solution. Because in every problem, there is a solution. So rather than see solution in every problem, they see problem in every solution, in every situation. They don't see things coming out good. So on the best days, this number of people with negative attitude, on the best day, they are still very miserable. On the best day, they are still very miserable. Three, negative attitude prevents us from enjoying life. It's all for you. If what I'm telling you now, you say, oh, why is it this pastor is just saying this all the time? It's all for you. Hello? It's all for you. As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we shall discourage negative attitude. as much as within my reach, negative attitude will prevent you from enjoying life. Will prevent you from enjoying the little God has given you. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17 explains that to us, that God gives us richly all things to enjoy. All things to enjoy. Your wife is giving you by God to enjoy. Your husband is giving you by God to do what? To enjoy. Even that certificate you have, that small diploma, you think it's nothing. I just have a degree. Who told you that somebody who has PhD is enjoying that more than you that has just one diploma? Who told you that? Who is saying that? You get to determine in your heart that whatever God has given you is for you to enjoy. Now forget about what God has given to that person over there. It's out of negative attitude that we begin to compare ourselves with ourselves. Those that compare themselves with themselves are not wise. They're not wise. That's what God gave you. Enjoy it. Amen?
Amen.
Enjoy it. He won't be the solution for the day. God gives us all things to enjoy. People with a negative attitude are so focused on the things that are going wrong or could be going wrong that they never really enjoy the good things of life which God has given them. Their focus is on things that are going wrong. Hey, it's not working very well. Hey, the stock market is going off. Oh, the amount of money I have in the bank. The government is going to know. Hey, that money is just. It's not sufficient. Let's make more, make more, make more, make more. They will make more, make more. Negative attitude. They never get enough. They believe until they start and start and start before things begin to happen. The Lord bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number four, negative attitude adversely affects the people around us. It's very contagious. People with negative attitude, for you to survive among them, you must have extra strength. They always come to you with this story of it's not possible. They always come to you. You know, it's often been said that mystery, as people always say, lost company. Mystery, lost company. So, negative attitude is contagious. It's like cold. A person with negative attitude makes everyone around them miserable. Everyone around them is in trouble. Everyone. If anything happens to them, all of you don't have peace. Until the solution comes. All of you. You are the mother, you are the father, you are a friend, you are anyone around them. They get a problem, you are all a problem. Negative attitude adversely affects people around us. Let's look at this illustration. Even the answer to a question depends on how you ask it. If I want you to eat from what I have on my table, the food on my table, where I can ask you, and you will be willing to eat. And if I don't want you to eat from that food, there's a way I will ask you. And even when you are hungry, you will think twice. I want to leave this illustration. You know? I went to a secondary school somewhere in a place where they have this approach. Anytime people are going on the street, I grew up mostly in Lagos. So I went to secondary school in Osun State now. Formerly Oyo State, but now Osun State. I don't want to mention the town, I don't want to feel bad, but it is the approach of people in that town. Anytime they are meeting people, they say, come inside, come and eat. Come inside, come. Every time they greet people, go on the street. Come inside, come and eat. Come inside, come and eat. It's their way, it's common. So one day somebody actually came inside. True life story. They came inside. So the woman, the elderly one quickly for somebody to go out and buy something. To go out and buy, and then again, this person is talking. And they like akamu, that is, you know, grain, you know, this thing you do from grain. I don't have to explain the language. Ah. So people say to go and bring and buy that thing so they can. Because The food is not in the house per se. It's just the common way to greet people. And some people, when they put food, they come and eat. They don't want you to come and eat, but they don't want to eat while you are just waiting. They invite you, but from their heart, the food is not even sufficient for them. Amen?
Amen.
Negative attitude is very contagious. So look at this psychology student. Decided to test this theory on his face. Not to test this theory on his face, that negative attitude is contagious. So he volunteered to pass out the apples to his mates while they were up on a queue for their meal. He went down. First one, this is the first apple, said, the way he has the question, said, the first on the queue, he said, and asked him, "You don't want apples, do you? You don't want apples, do you?" 90% of the students answered no. No, he was having a bad shade of apple. Look at that question. "You don't want apples, do you?" So he went on the next thing. Ask the same question, they say, "Do you want apples, don't you?" About 50% said yes. And look at the way the third way he asked the question, the third one. "One apple or two?" Another line. "You want one apple or two?" Look at the answer. And despite the fact that the most of the students don't like the apples. Now listen, 40% took two. 50% took one. Only 10% declined. It's all in the attitude. It's all in the attitude. Negative attitude affects the way people respond to us, the way we respond to people, and it's contagious. Number five, negative attitude limits God's power in our lives. It limits God's power. Millions of Israelites left Egypt with the promise that they are going to promise land. Negative attitude hindered thousands of them from getting to promised land. Negative attitude. Numbers chapter 14 from verse 26. "And the Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron, saying, 'How long shall I bear with this evil congregation? Who complained against me?'" Negative attitude brings complaints. It brings complaint. It encourages complaint. Negative attitude. And God said, "I have had the complaints which the children of Israel made against me. Say to them, 'As I live, says the Lord, just as you have spoken in my hearing, so I will do to you.' The carcasses of you who have complained against me shall fall in this wilderness. All of you who were numbered according to your entire number, from 20 years old and above." So the issue of attitude affects everything we do, even spiritually. The gift God has given you, attitude we expect it will maximize every opportunity. The ministry God has committed to your hands, attitude we expect either you will do it or not. The opportunities that you have, opportunities that will come your way in life, attitude we expect either you will embrace every opportunity, either you walk through every door or not. Attitude. So these people, millions of them perished in the wilderness just because of negative attitude, complaining, forgetting what God has done in the past for them. Negative attitude. Number six, negative attitude hinders your intimacy with God and robs you of God's blessings. Negative attitude hinders your intimacy with God and robs you of God's blessings. If you continue to complain, God does not want people that complainers. As a matter of fact, I have told you, in so many organizations, they do not want people that complain. They don't want people that. It's hard to promote somebody who complains because you never satisfy them. Even if you give them double promotion, you never satisfy these people. James chapter 1 from verse 5 to 8, James chapter 1 from verse 5 to 8, says, "If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to him. Verse 6. But let him ask in faith, with no doubting, for evil doubt is like a wave of the sea, driven and tossed by the wind. For let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. He is a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. So doubt will rob us of God's blessings, and negative attitude brings doubt. Hello? Brings doubt. Seven truths about attitude. Let's try to see if we can answer some of them. If we can get them, so we can continue in the part seven. Truths about attitude. I have like seven. So if I can do three or four, whatever, or if I can play anything, we will see. Attitude determines approach. Truth about attitude. Attitude determines what? Approach. If your attitude towards the world is great, the world's attitude towards you will be great. Your approach to anything in life will determine your success or failure at that thing. The way you approach something, a task given to you, your attitude will determine. If that assignment will be successful or not. So, one of the truths in attitude is attitude determines approach. Approach to the task, approach to the assignment. Look at the talent that Jesus explained about the Bible of talents. Look at the one that was given one. His attitude robbed him of God's blessings. His attitude towards that robbed him of God's blessings. Some people go through that as if life is their only one who has challenged life. They carry their problem on their heads. As you are seeing them, their faces, the way they put it, they are never happy because of that. Even when God will do it, they will not be happy with that. Because they are not used to they develop this kind of attitude of being sorrowful all the time. Listen, you cannot tailor make the situations. You cannot say, let me tell you the situations. Because sometimes we can't control situations. We cannot control circumstances coming our ways. We can't control it. It's like a child who has not been born, who's trying to choose his father or his mother. Is that possible? Or trying to choose his nation.